saw the project online. I saw the building was for sale. It was an old dilapidated fish shack. I thought it was a very interesting building. In the process of doing the due diligence, I got a call from A.R.C. company, and they were trying to put a upweller in there with using this as a nursery for shellfish. I said this would be a great use for the property, so we went on the venue that we're going to try to do a new building here. So I said I need more help, and I want to get an engineering firm involved with me that's very familiar with work on the waterfront, and especially with conservation and Chapter 91 DEP. So I hired Coastal Engineering.
We made submittal to the local conservation commission here in Harwich and had our first hearing, and lo and behold, some of the abutters came with some experts on their own, and they started bringing to light what they deemed to be deficiencies or faults with the project. And that really started a journey for Fran that continued on and got more and more and more difficult as we got into the permitting process. Ultimately, after a long battle, hard-fought battle, we did receive formal approval from the state at that level. In the meantime, Fran, this takes months and months and months, so in the meantime, Fran decided to regroup and decided to just try to just renovate the building that presently existed at that time, and that's what you see here today.
The building back in February 2016 was just about ready to fall in the water.
There's a process for the emergency provision under the Wetlands Protection Act that allows structures that are in the coastal zone to be repaired under an emergency request as long as two town officials sign off and agree that it is a threat to public safety as well as the wetland resource areas.
I went to a colleague of mine, roommate from undergraduate school, he's a structural engineer, and I explained the problem. He came down, looked at it, he said, you know, we don't have much time to do this, it's really failing. And the harbor master was there and the conservation was there. So he worked about 3 or 4 days, day and night, and he came up with an innovative plan, which has never been done before. And we're just going to keep our fingers crossed it was going to work. And we went right at it and used steel, structural steel, with some piles to stabilize the building.
So Fran was able to get a contractor in here and actually build everything. And as you can see, it's a pretty benign project. And I can notice myself when I'm standing, I hear the birds and I hear the upwellers and I hear the actual shellfish, you know, bubbling, but it's not offensive. It's actually a really nice project.
I currently work on the four upwellers here for the nursery. We have a hatchery in Dennis, so once the seeds and the babies get to a certain size, they can come outside to upwellers where water gets pumped in through a drain, and then they go into the water. And that's where the filter feeders, like the oysters and clams, filter the water, and then the clean water goes back into the ocean. The difference that this ocean has made compared to the Dennis is insane. The growth is insanely more. Clams love this water. Everything that was growing maybe 1 or 2 millimeters for the whole summer in Dennis is growing like 1 or 2 millimeters in like a week here. You could see like the algae in the water. You could tell that the clams and oysters are really happy here. So we have three types of shellfish here. We have cohogs, we have oysters, and then we have surf clams, also known as butter clams. So we have some right here. These are some of our smallest oysters. They started off as 5 millimeters. And these ones are our largest. These are 12 millimeters. These are our surf clams in the middle. They like to move. And then we have two sets of cohogs. Once they get to a certain size, we either bring them to our own grants or we sell them to other oyster clam farmers. And we supply about 80% of clams and oysters on Cape.
If you notice the sign, the Fish House Redemption, I needed to put some type of name on the building. I found the word redemption, which means save from evil. Saving was saving the fish house, the original fish house. So I called it the Fish House Redemption. So everyone likes the name, by the way. Except those three neighbors. It was just, you know, we really went overboard on the aesthetics. We, you know, put new roof, new siding. We put railings, we put decks, we put windows. We really architecturally took the fish house and made it more compatible with the neighborhood. Actually, people drive by, they think it's a house someone's living in here. So it's not really set up like a commercial building would be. It's more set up for residential to fit with the architecture of the neighborhood. And the town likes it. Everyone's really proud of it. It's something that I own the property now, but I'm only the steward of the property. You know, eventually it has to be passed on. And I'm figuring if A.R.C. wants to purchase it or the town, keep it as an Upweller. I think it'll last forever. It'll be sustainable food for the Cape. Kids in high school can come in and look at this and learn about aquaculture. And I think it has a lot of educational value. It has a lot of practical value, environmental value, more so than just the real estate value. I talked to my accountant and he said, you know, I said, Joe, when can I break even on all the money I put into it? And he said, you'd be 138 years old before you get your money back. So I guess, you know, it's not a good investment, but I think it's an investment really for the Cape itself.